Let us start the lecture on D'Alembert's principle. What I say? D'Alembert's principle. Just first write down
D'Alembert's principle. Okay. D'Alembert's principle.
How does this D'Alembert's principle say us? We already studied the principle of virtual work, yes or no? In principle of virtual work, actually we study the problem which is in static, that is in the derivation of principle of virtual work, from the starting onwards we take the net force on the particle is equal to zero, that is the particle is in equilibrium, or you can say the system is in equilibrium, yes or no? In principle of virtual work, what do we study?
In principle of virtual work,
what do you study? The system is in equilibrium. That is, you can say equilibrium means static rest, yes or no? We can say we apply this principle of virtual work only for the static problem, yes or no? What I say? Principle of virtual work is applies to the system in equilibrium. Okay. Or we can say static problem. What I say? Static problem. Okay. Then what is the role of D'Alembert's principle? In D'Alembert's principle, we extend the principle of virtual work to use or to apply in dynamic problem. That the problem which is in dynamic. Yes or no? What D'Alembert's principle says?
Just write down here D'Alembert's principle. This is the small concept of D'Alembert's principle. Okay. What D'Alembert's principle says? D'Alembert's principle says you can write extension of the principle of virtual work to apply on the dynamical problem. You see, what can I write here? Extend the principle of virtual work to apply in the problem of dynamic, in the dynamical problem.
How we can apply this principle of virtual work in dynamical problem? This concept says by the D'Alembert's principle. Okay. Then just start the derivation. Okay. First write down, we have to take the system consisting of n particle, and there is a particle which is named as I, yes or no?
Just write down. Consider a system of
n particle.
Let m I be the m I is in subscript, that is mass of I particle, yes or no? Let m I be the mass of the I particle and r I
is the position vector in configurational space, yes or no? That is, here you can write ri is the position coordinate, or you can write position vector also. Just write down position coordinate here. The starting lecture we write this coordinate, so just write down
R I is the position coordinate of ith particle. Okay, m I is the mass of the ith particle and R I is the position of the ith particle. Then we know momentum, the formula for momentum, p equal to m into v, or you can write m r dot. Yes or no? This is the formula for momentum. Then the momentum becomes, then here you can write just try again m I r I dot. R I dot means velocity. Okay, m I r I dot is the momentum of ith particle. M I r I is the momentum of ith particle. Then if f I is the total force, F I is the total force on the ith particle, yes or no? F I is the total force on the ith particle, then from Newton's law, what we have? Newton's second law. From the Newton's second law, force equal to rate of change of momentum, yes or no? Just write down this one. Force F, that is F I, is equal to rate of change of momentum, or we can write here M R I double dot, yes or no? For P, we have to write the M I R I dot as M I is constant. So M I comes out, and the differentiation of R I dot is R I double dot, that is M I here. Just write M I R I double dot, yes or no? This is our momentum. Just see what you got here. Here you can say M I is the mass of the particle, yes or no? What I got? R I double dot, that is the acceleration, yes or no? Just write it as the acceleration. This one is the acceleration of ith particle, yes or no? This one is the acceleration of ith particle. What does it mean? It says due to the force fi, the ith particle move with a acceleration r I double dot, yes or no? The ith particle moves with a acceleration r I double dot, which generated a effective force m I r I double dot, yes or no? Just see, again I see, f I is the force here, right? If f I is the total force on the ith particle, okay, as this force applied on the ith particle, so r I double dot means acceleration of the ith particle, yes or no? Due to this force, the ith particle starts moving with an acceleration r I double dot, which generate, as the particle has mass m I, here we can say which generate the effective force m I r I double dot, yes or no? Just write down this one. What can I write here? Due to the force f I, due to the force f I, the ith particle develops a motion with acceleration r I double dot, yes or no? Just write down. Due to the force F I, due to the force F I,
The ith particle
develops a motion. Ith particle develops a motion of acceleration of acceleration ri double dot, yes or no? Ri double dot and generated an effective force, that is mi ri double dot. Yes or no? Generated an effective force. Let this one be the equation one. This one be the equation 1. And just see what you got here. Here you can say the effective force is equal to the total force. Yes or no? You can say the effective force is equal to the total force. And you can write here equation 1 reduces to what? You can write here minus mi ri double dot plus fi equal to 0, yes or no? Just take the mi ri double dot from RHS to LHS. What I got? Minus mi ri double dot plus fi is equal to 0. Just see this equation. Here I have a minus symbol and here is a plus symbol. What I say here? Mi ri double dot. What is mi ri double dot? Mi ri double dot is the effective force. Yes or no? Mi ri double dot is effective force. As here I have a minus, so we can say this one is the reverse effective force. Yes or no? Yes or no? Then just see this equation. Let this is the equation. No, just see this equation. This one is the reverse effective force, which is due to the motion of the ice particle with an acceleration ri double dot inside the system. Then just see this one is the force and this one is the another force. The equilibrium, yes or no? By adding these two forces, we got the value 0. That means the ith particle is in equilibrium. Yes or no? Ith particle is in equilibrium means here we can apply the principle of virtual work. Yes or no? Just see here. Or you can write here equation 2 says that the system is in equilibrium, yes or no? As here you got the equilibrium system, that is static system. That means here you can say problem becomes static problem. Yes or no? That is, the system is in equilibrium under the mixed applied force and reverse effective force. Yes or no? Hence, as we got a static system here, so here you can apply the principle of virtual work. Yes or no? Just apply the principle of virtual work. Applying principle of virtual work. Here, just write. Here we can apply principle of virtual work. Yes or no? Apply principle of virtual work. Then just see what I do. In principle of virtual work, we have the formula fi applied dot delta ri equal to 0, yes or no? In that place, delta ri is the virtual displacement, yes or no?
Just write down this one, this expression.
Here you can write sum over I bracket start MI RI double dot, sorry, minus is here, minus MIRI double dot plus FI dot delta RI is equal to 0. Delta RI is a virtual displacement, yes or no? Just write down here, delta RI is the virtual displacement. Displacement. Yes or no?
Then, in the concept of principle of virtual arc, we have this FI, this total force is the combination of external applied force and the constant force, yes or no? Just write down this one, but FI is the FI applied plus FI constant, yes or no? This FI applied is the external applied force, and this one is our force of constant. Force of constant, yes or no? But in the principle of virtual arc, we have constant force do not do any virtual work, yes or no? So this term can be eliminated, yes or no? Just write down this one. In the principle of virtual arc, we have constant force do not perform any virtual work. Just erase this one. No, right. We have but constraint force do not perform any virtual work. So FI C dot delta RI is equal to 0. Yes or no? Let this is the equation 3. Hence, equation 3, sorry, let this one is the 4, this one is the equation 3. Hence, equation 3 reduces to, hence, equation 3 reduces to, what do you got here? Sum over I minus MI RI double dot plus FI applied dot delta is equal to 0. Okay. Just write down PI in place of MI RI dot. Let's see here. We know P is the MI RI dot. That means PI dot P dot means MI RI double dot, yes or no? If we differentiate P with respect to time, then what you got? Mass is the constant quantity with respect to time, yes or no? So only RI can be derivated. Okay. So what you got here? RI double dot, yes or no? Just write out P dot in place of, sorry, as I write I here, so here you have to write I. PI dot in place of MI RI double dot. What I got here? Sum over I minus PI dot plus FI apply dot delta RI is equal to 0. Yes or no? Okay, let this one is the equation high. in this
where pi dot is equal to mi ri double dot and delta ri is the virtual displacement. Okay.
Why study this D'Alembert principle? In the first case, we can say this is the extended form of principle of virtual work. That is, the principle of virtual work is only applicable for the static problem. But here in D'Alembert principle, we use this principle of virtual work in a dynamical problem. And the another thing, from the D'Alembert principle, we can derive the Lagrangian equation of motion. Yes or no? That's our aim. We have to find the Lagrangian equation of motion from the D'Alembert principle. That is, we can use this equation. We will use this equation 5, to find out the Lagrangian equation of motion. Yes or no? This is all about the class on D'Alembert's principle. Okay.